Hey there. I'm currently working on the cockpit of my F101, and I needed to create some cable ties and cable bundles in the back here. So I thought I'd take a few minutes out of the project and demonstrate how I made these cable bundles. So let's move this out of the way. Bring in a fresh scene. So we're going to start with a Bezier curve. So just add the curve. And go into edit mode and give it another subdivide there and just kind of move it around and make it, whatever shape you need it to be. Something interesting here. And just looking at it from the top, I'm gonna take the whole thing, duplicate it, maybe move it there, change things up a little bit so we get some twisting around, a little randomness. And this is all the same object. I don't have different Bezier curve objects. I only got the one. So let me just select one more, duplicate it, rotate a little bit. You rotate it like that. So now we've got our cable framework. Let's go down here to the data properties, or the object data properties tab, and we want to go down to the depth value and just scroll through this and make them bigger. This is going to be the total thickness of the cable bundles. So maybe a little smaller in that. And let's edit these so they don't intersect so much. Just give them some space there so they're distinct bundles. All right, so that looks pretty good. And we want to take this and we're going to convert it to a mesh. So right click. Convert to mesh. Now if we go back into edit mode, you can see we've got our meshes like that. And now I'm going to select some rings of faces, and while looking kind of straight on at them, kind of like straight down the barrel like that, I'm going to turn on proportional editing. So I hit O, turn on proportional editing. You can see it's on up there, and you want to make sure the connected only is enabled. Now if I rotate, I can just kind of twist, I can add some twist to these things. I'm just going to go through and do the same thing for a lot of these. Maybe increase my radius a little bit. And this is just going to add a little bit of interest to the cable so they're not just straight through. We're going just kind of create some randomness there. The reason I'm looking straight down is that way I just rotate it mostly around the length of the cable bundle and not, cockeyed like that. I don't want to do that. I want it to be around the axis of the cables. So just almost done here. And we'll just do one more. All right, so now we've got our twists in. Now what I want to do is I want to select some edge loops, which is going to be the location of the cable ties, so where the cables get pinched together. So just kind of every once in a while double click on an edge loop where you want a cable tie to be. And just kind of go around here, make one there. Almost done. Yeah, that's good enough. All right, so now making sure that the object is scaled properly, because the bevel tool works better when things are scaled. So in edit mode, Control B to bevel. I'm just going to expand that out a little bit to create these rings, and I'm going to hit Alt S. Oh, I don't want to be in proportional, so Alt S, and just scale these in, and that's going to create the pinching for our cable ties. So let's duplicate those. So Shift D, right click to cancel our movement, P to make a separate selection. So I'm going to call this one ties, just keep it neat, and we're going to hide that for the moment. Let's go back to these guys. I'm going to edit mode. I'm going to select everything. Shift D to duplicate, right click to cancel my movement, Alt S, and I'm going to scale my cables in a little bit. So I have kind of pipes inside of pipes. And now I just need to select the lengthwise one edge of each one of these pipes. So You can see I've got my pipe going all the way up there, and then I go up to select, loop select, or select loops, and then edge rings, and that'll give me selections all the way down the length of all the pipes. I can shift D to duplicate that, right click to cancel the movement, P to separate. I want to separate by selection. And now I want to hide the other one. We're done with that for now. So now we just have our cable foundation. We can right click on this and we convert that to a curve, back to a curve again. And we can go back down here and add some depth and make our wires. So let's right click and smooth that. So we got some smoothness, and let's add a subdivision as well. All right, so we got our wires going, that's cool. And we can put our ties back on. So let's select our ties, go into edit mode, A to select all, and hit Alt S, and I'm gonna scale these up. So they're outside of the wires now. Maybe a little bit more, like that. And I can add a solidify modifier to that. Maybe five millimeters. And shade smooth. Now let's just go down here just for expediency. We'll just use the normals to give a nice edge on that. You of course could, you know, texture this stuff any way you want, but that's at least the basis for the tiles or the cables. If we want to take this one step further, we can add a shader to these. So let's select the cables. I'll move this back up and go here and create a new material, and we'll call it cables. All right, let's go into edit mode. I'm just going to select strands of this at random by putting my mouse over a point and hitting the L key, and that's going to select all the connected points. I'm going to select a bunch, hit P, separate, and you can see that that's created a set of a separate set of wires. So I'm going to do that again, like maybe four or five at a time, just taking different ones out. And this is going to allow us to use the random function within the shader to assign some random colors to our wires. And I found that the more the more cable groups you have, the more variety of colors you can have successfully. So I'm just going to create a bunch of them here. Select that. Like those. And I'm just, you know, going in, selecting a bunch, separating them, and then just going back to object mode quickly just to hide the one that I just did. Just makes it a little bit easier for me to see what's going on. That one's a little harder because of the coloring. But it's right there. And maybe one more. So now you can see we've got a nice variety of objects there. So let's go into our shader editor. And let's start by adding an object info node. So search object info. And we can use the random function of this. So this function right there, and I'll just turn this on for a second, render, and you can see that gives us shades of gray for each of the wire groups. And we can use that if we feed that through a color ramp, converter color ramp. And let's put that into our principal shader. And instead of just black and whites, let's make some colorful wires. Here we got some blue wires, we got some white wires. Let's make some red wires, and let's change this to constant. And maybe just add a couple more colors here, just some, we get some variety going on. Put this one up there, make it maybe yellow. So you can see we quickly create a bunch of different colors for our wires. We can make this a little bit more interesting if we add an ambient occlusion node. So search for ambient occlusion. And let's add a math node to this, so converter math. And we want the ambient occlusion to go to the top value, change this to a power function, and let's make the exponent 3. And just to see what that looks like, you can see how that creates these nice dark shadows between the wires. And we can use that to adjust the coloring coming into the principal shader. So let me move this, give us some room here. Connect that one back up. So I want to add a mix color mix node, so mix color. And we're going to take the ambient occlusion, use that as the factor. I'm going to take the value coming straight out of the color ramp, stick it in the bottom there. And I'm going to add a color RGB curves node. I'm just going to stick it right there. And let's put the color coming out of here, here. And you can see that with this guy selected, I can then just darken my colors. Not adding black, I'm just making darker colors. And then if I feed that into my color mix node, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the darker colors where the shadows are and the lighter colors where the shadows aren't. And we can see what that looks like now. And you can see we've got like some really nice depth to our wires. We've got some deep shadows going on there. So that's nice. See what else? If you wanted to, you could certainly go in here. If these were too saturated, you could desaturate these a bit if they were too bright. And one other thing, if you wanted to add maybe a little bit more interest to them, let's add a search for magic. I'm going to add a magic texture to this. And I don't need the mapping. And I just want it on the generated. And let's just take a look what this looks like. I just want the factor like that. So let's go this, crank this up. And if you crank it up enough, you get this kind of almost cloth type weave pattern that happens inside the magic texture. So let's put that there. And let's move this guy back a bit here. And I'm going to add a color, another mix color. This one I'm going to set to screen. I'm going to place the random function into the top value, and I'm going to place the I'm going to place the color into here. So you can see we get kind of a mix. So we get this overlay of from the magic texture on top of our random color, and then I can put this back into here. And what that's going to do is going to kind of create some extra markings on the wires just to give them some interest. You can see how sometimes cables have striping or dots or other marks to make them a little more interesting. So totally optional. If you wanted to put those on there or not, certainly crank this up to a bigger number. I think probably look better. Maybe 500. Try that. All right, and there you go. Quick and easy cable bundles. All right, so I hope that was helpful. I will see you in the next video, I hope. Good luck with your projects.